Welcome, everybody, to this edition of Peninsula Symphony AllStars at Home. We're delighted to have you with us. One of the things that we're most pleased in this pandemic era about is that we can continue our music outreach for Peninsula Symphony. And a wonderful example of that will be that we will be able to have the 15th annual Marilyn Mindell Piano Competition conducted virtually with everybody performing their competition performances online and the judges evaluating those, and we'll be able to select winners and award prizes. And so this particular aspect of the Bridges to Music program, the education outreach program of the Peninsula Symphony, will go on this year, and we're very pleased about that. So tonight's program kind of melds two aspects. It's our educational outreach and our virtual programming. And we're glad today to welcome the director, artistic director of the Marilyn Mindell Piano Competition for all of its decade and a half history, Heidi Howe. Welcome, Heidi.
Thank you. Good to be here.
And we're delighted you're with us. And we have with us today the Peninsula Symphony's assistant conductor who collaborates with the winner of the senior division of the Mindell competition in performance, and welcome to Ho Chen, our assistant conductor. Hi, Ho.
Hi, thanks, Mitch. Nice to be here.
Great to have you with us. And then finally, and possibly most importantly, the winner of the 2019 Marilyn Mindell competition, Solomon Guh. We're delighted you're with us, Solomon. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
And we are going to start with some music. Let's find out what it's like to be a performer at the level of the Marilyn Mindell Senior Division winner. We would like to have Solomon start by playing three movements of the Bach First Partita for keyboard, the Prelude, Allemande, and Corrente. So Solomon playing Bach. Here we go, whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Bach is amazing. We're hearing a lot of Bach in the COVID era. It seems like musicians are going back to basics and the music that is really at the core of who we are. In 2005, I was approached by an old friend of mine and of the Peninsula Symphony named Harold Mindell, who was hoping to find an appropriate memorial event for his late wife, Marilyn. Marilyn Mindell was prominent piano teacher on the peninsula, based in San Mateo. And she had been active all her life, very, very powerful force for musical organizations all over the peninsula, including the Peninsula Symphony. In fact, she was one of the leaders of a program to help renovate the San Mateo Performing Arts Center and to install a fine piano there, which was used for many years by the Peninsula Symphony. And so we talked for a while about what might be an appropriate kind of event, and Hal Mindell was prepared to make a donation to give us a head start on this. And we eventually decided a piano competition, a chance to feature the finest young pianists in the peninsula area, San Mateo County, Santa Clara County, San Francisco, in an event where they have a chance to show their accomplishment and have a chance to perform in the before the public. That would be a wonderful way to celebrate the legacy of Marilyn Mindell. So I contacted Heidi Howe, a piano teacher and pianist of great success and renown, who I'd known for a number of years, and we talked about creating this competition. What are some of your first memories about Heidi, about how we decided to go about creating this competition?
So originally the competition was just for seniors, for high school. And being that through a large part of my life, I did competitions as a youth and adult, I won a competition that was a little bit different in the sense that usually in competitions, a contestant plays in the first round and certain contestants are eliminated. This competition is a little different because the contestants, all of them, get two chances to play for the judges, to impress the judges, in the first round with the movement of a sonata and in the second round with the movement of a concerto. And it gives them ample opportunity to play all that they practice because, you know, these pianists work so hard. In addition to this competition, we have a second category, which we expanded the competition later, for juniors, for the younger age group, because this Bay Area is, we have so many really talented young musicians, and we wanted a competition to really showcase that. So I think my memories are just hearing how every year the competition gets more difficult because the level is so much higher every year. So it's impressive. It's exciting to hear every year, frankly.
Yeah, it really is. The junior level, which is ages, essentially
10 to 14.
Yeah. So essentially middle school and younger.
Yeah.
We have just one after another, of these very minute individuals, small kids, who come out and just knock the socks off.
Yeah.
Fabulous, wonderful pieces. They're so impressive. They're so poised. They're so smart and musically very, very sophisticated and dedicated. So it's really quite an impressive thing. But in the senior division, it's quite a challenge for the competitors. Ho has experienced this now as having served as a judge. When you have to play a sonata and then come back and play a concerto, accompanied by a second pianist, the jury is seeing many, many different sides of your musicianship, and it's challenging. What was your experience, Ho, of judging in terms of evaluating the sonatas and the concertos?
I think it's really helpful to have both both forms in the competition. You get to see the artistry alone in the sonatas, and really, when it comes to the senior division, it really came down to splitting a lot of hairs, right? I'm sure you would agree. And then when it comes to the competition part, you know, and with the such a great accompanist like Dimitri, for me, it came down to really which of the soloists could communicate and work best with the accompanist. So in that, as in order to prepare a concerto in, you know, one rehearsal, that's, that was a very important consideration on my end.
Yeah, the accompanist that Ho is referring to is Dmitry Kogan, extraordinary accompanist who is, I guess it's safe to say, one of the leading accompanists in California, and who knows the entire literature inside and out, and who's also a wonderful musician. And it's that in the concerto part of the competition, it is that musical back and forth that really sets them apart. We will always hear six excellent pianists playing their parts well, but it's the musicality, it is the musical statement that makes the piece really come to life that separates one from another, and where Solomon was so impressive in his Prokofiev year before last. We were also lucky because Heidi Howe is well connected to her musical roots at Stanford University. And so we've always been able to hold the competition until this year at Campbell Recital Hall at Stanford. And we've had the collaboration of Frederick Weldy from the piano faculty. So I'm sure that's been fun for you, Heidi, to continue to bring Stanford and the Peninsula Symphony together.
I love going back to Stanford, so I have no complaints going there to hold the competition. And Fred Weldy is a very good friend of mine, and he's been there since day one of the competition.
Yeah, he's judged every year.
He's judged every single year without fail. So we're super pleased that he's there all the time.
And we also have had a number of other pianists judge, serve on the jury of the competition over the years. Somehow or another, that initial investment that the Mindell family made into this competition has stretched and enabled us to continue to do it and continue to see the competition grow in significance on the Bay Area scene. So Solomon, how did you prepare for the competition?
Kind of a different approach for me for the sonata and the concerto. For the sonata, I kind of focused more on just showcasing myself, and I was able to take more freedoms just because, like, I'm by myself on the stage. And with the concerto, as Ho mentioned, I prioritized, like, you know, ensemble, being together with Mr. Kogan. And actually, when I started learning the concerto and I played it for my teacher, for the first few weeks, the only things he told me were, like, play louder, project over an orchestra, and just play in tempo. So I definitely think those are very important for concertos, especially when you have one rehearsal to just be in tempo and know where everything is.
Yeah, the challenges of the sonata and the concerto are very different. And I think one of the things that pianists learn from this competition is that you do have to prepare to play a concerto quite differently. You have to be able to collaborate with a conductor. You don't want to throw the conductor curves that are just hard to follow. How'd that work out for you, Ho?
You know, as far as if you're familiar with the Prokofiev concerto, it's like a, in some points, it's like a runaway train. But as far as trains go, Solomon was a very forgiving and flexible one. So it was actually really made my job easy because we were able to meet and discuss how we approach the pieces and then really come to consensus and really a lot of give and take. Mostly a lot of Solomon was giving to allow us to work with him. So it was very flexible, very, very easy.
So we'll talk a little bit more about that, but now I think it's time to hear some more Bach. Solomon, are you ready? If you will, let us hear the remaining movements of the Bach first partita, the Sarabande, the two minuets, and the Gigue. Are you ready? All right, here we go. Solomon, go. Thank you. That was terrific, Solomon. Thank you very much. So Solomon and Ho put together a performance of the first movement of the Prokofiev Third Piano Concerto, a mighty powerful piece of music. And anybody who was in the audience would have assumed that you both had performed the piece numerous times. Was that the case?
No, that was, we had rehearsed once and then we had a dress rehearsal and then was the performance. That was actually my first time performing with orchestra as well, but it went really well and I was very happy.
It did go extremely well and you should have been very happy, absolutely. But watching the two of you rehearse, I would never have guessed this was your first concerto experience with orchestra. Ho, had you performed this piece before?
Oh, and actually this is one of my, you know, handful of piano concerti that I've performed. So it was an awesome experience. Really, the Peninsula Symphony is such a great orchestra. They learn so quickly. Like you said, one of the challenges I felt was how do we make the orchestra sound like as familiar with the piece as Solomon is? And frankly, I think they were up for the task and really did well.
Yeah, they certainly did. It's just a massive undertaking and requires a big sound, a big piano sound. And tell me about the preparation that the two of you did prior to the first rehearsal and what the experience of that first rehearsal was like.
It was really nice. Solomon was flexible enough to meet me at the conservatory. I think he had a lesson there, so it was really good timing. At the meeting, it didn't take too long. I just wanted to get some relative tempos and just had him play through the piece. We chat a little bit about, you know, where we would need to connect and where we need to make sure that things didn't fall apart. And that was that. That was probably the easiest part of the whole process, just working with Solomon alone. And then once we started rehearsing, then we started to see a lot of the challenges that we had discussed and just worked our way through them.
Did you start at the rehearsal? I mean, I was there, so I know the answer, but I'm going to ask you anyway. Did you start rehearsing with Solomon, or did you start with just the with the orchestra to get them settled into what some of your ideas would be?
Oh no, I think we definitely took some time to start without Solomon.
And my experience was that as soon as he started playing, it was a unified approach to the rehearsal. What was your experience, Solomon? This was your first time playing a concerto in a rehearsal with a symphony orchestra. Was it what you expected?
Well, I really wasn't sure what to expect, but it was probably one of my coolest musical experiences. I remember when Ho first had the orchestra play and had me not play, I just remember hearing the clarinet line and I'm like, wow, there's actually clarinets there. That's not second piano now. Well, he was working with the orchestra originally. I was just like, I really want to be playing right now. And then when he had me enter, it was so cool. It was nothing I've ever felt before.
Yeah, it's an amazing experience and requires a different approach. You hinted on at this a little bit earlier. When you're playing a concerto with an orchestra, you cannot be quite so free. You have to anticipate what the orchestra will be listening for and how you can avoid making things more difficult for them than it needs to be, but still maintain your artistic vision. How'd that work out for you?
With Prokofiev, it was actually somewhat straightforward. I think with something like Rachmaninoff, for example, you need to take rubato to be expressive. But with Prokofiev, there is a very expressive middle section, but quite a lot of it has a lot of just ostinato drive and doesn't really require much bending of tempo. So my teacher just instructed me to practice with great rhythmic precision and in a way that, you know, when I listen back to my recording, I can easily conduct. That was for me like you, that I was doing well.
Yeah, I thought it worked beautifully right from the beginning, and one had the impression that the two of you had worked together before, just kind of knew how to listen to each other and anticipate each other, and that you were both veterans with this piece. So it came off brilliantly right from the beginning. Heidi has been soloist with the Peninsula Symphony and other orchestras, many other orchestras, and competition winner herself. And we're going to conclude today's program with a performance that Heidi recorded of the Chopin Andante Spianato and Grand Polonaise, gigantic and wonderful and highly familiar Chopin work. Can you tell us a little bit about this performance that you did?
This was actually an all Chopin concert held at Old First Church in San Francisco. And it was organized by a friend and colleague of mine at the San Francisco Conservatory, Bill Wellborn. So I closed the concert with this piece. And funny enough, there was actually also an all Beethoven concert that was supposed to happen, but due to COVID has been postponed indefinitely, so.
Well, we hope that that will come back. Let's conclude just by reviewing for everybody what we're doing this year in this unusual year, starting with Solomon. What's this year been like for you, and what are your plans for the rest of this year?
It's certainly been a very strange year. I'm trying to adjust, and I've had a lot of time to learn new repertoire and just practice. And I have auditions coming up. They're not going to be live because of COVID restrictions, but I will have to make a recording.
So will you make the same recording for each of the places you're auditioning, or do they all require different repertoire and different samplings of your pianism?
They have slightly different requirements, but I will be able to recycle some recordings.
That's terrific. And so you've taken this as a gap year.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect year to be gapping.
Yes.
The rest of us are just kind of gaping. I'm busy with all the virtual activities that the Peninsula Symphony and Peninsula Youth Orchestra and Klein Competition are doing. And that keeps me almost as busy as a normal year, with a lot less time in the car. So it hasn't been a total loss for me. And the expanding of the Peninsula Symphony's range online has actually been a very good thing we've talked about doing for many years. But I'm sure that many of the things that we've had to do this year out of necessity will turn out to be permanent parts of our musical life and our opportunity to serve the peninsula musically. Ho, you just got a new job outside music. What's this year been like for you?
It's definitely, been a tough year, but to be honest, before COVID happened, I'd been working, nonstop and with the orchestra and my other jobs. So it was good for me to take some time and just reflect and take some, that mental health check, which was very, very important. And now back at it, have a day job, but it's actually a lot better now, I find that in the Bay Area, a lot of the best music making is around this 9-to-5 day job. There's so many fantastic professional musicians or musical professionals. So, hopefully once this COVID business is taken care of, we can go back to making music with people again, which is something I miss quite a bit.
We sure look forward to being able to do that. I hope that's not too far off. What's this year been like for you, Heidi, musically?
Teaching completely virtually, so that's a whole new world. And obviously with the Mindell competition, how we're pivoting now to make it completely virtual. Just really finding time to get back to playing and practicing music. I think that especially during this year, with all the things that are happening, it's, I think, more essential and integral in my life to have something beautiful to listen to or something beautiful to play. And just listening to Solomon play, it's great to have that. It's great to appreciate something beautiful when unfortunately there's a lot of not so beautiful things around us sometimes when you turn on the news. But it's important to have music in our lives.
It sure is. And I have found for myself that I've connected to a number of online musical resources. I listen to the Metropolitan Opera broadcasts and watch the Berlin Philharmonic performances. It is a time to kind of wind down in a certain way and refocus. And if anything good is going to come out of all of this, I think it will come out of our looking inside a little bit more, since we are all inside, and figuring out what it is that makes us care about music as much as we do. Having said that, we're going to conclude tonight's program with Heidi Howe's splendid performance of the Chopin Andante Spianato and Grand Polonaise. And we'll move into that in just a moment. After I say thanks to Solomon Ge, we are so proud that you have been our winner and have performed so beautifully for the Mindell competition and the Peninsula Symphony family concert. Thank you for your beautiful performance today, and good luck through the rest of this year and into next year.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's been a pleasure. Ho, we look forward to working together. I need to talk to you about a musical project that's coming up. So we look forward to lots more musical things together and orchestra Zooms and various events. Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you, Mitch. It was really great. Thank you.
And Heidi, are there any words you'd like to tell us about Chopin and the Andante Spianato?
This is a piece that's been with me for a while. It starts off in sort of typical Chopin way, kind of sounds like a nocturne, very calm and tranquil. And then it gets into something a little bit more confident and virtuoso. So it kind of shows two sides of Chopin, which is why it makes it great fun. And of course, there's the ending. And I'll just say, wait for the ending.
It's a thriller, no question about it. So thank you, Solomon Ge, Ho Chen, Heidi Howe, and now let's enjoy Heidi's performance of the Chopin Andante Spianato and Grand Polonaise. Here we go. Thank you.
more content like this from Peninsula Symphony, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the red subscribe button below and tap the alarm bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded. Thanks for watching.